the British music phenomenon and multi-instrumentalist, best known for his ambitious blend of genres and electrifying live performances.
Yeah, those were some nice songs there. Now, the five-time Grammy winner is set to make a return down under. The great Jacob Collier joins us now. Good morning, Jacob. Such a pleasure to speak to you.
What's up, you guys?
Huge news that you're coming here. You're going to be bringing your Jesse World Tour to Australia this December. You're currently performing mega sellout shows across the globe. You just play with Coldplay, of course. Are you still pinching yourself?
Every day of my life, I pinch myself. It's such a miraculous thing to be doing what I do and to be traveling the world and to be making music, especially after COVID. It's such a cathartic and wonderful feeling. Spectacular, yeah.
And it brings so much joy. You made your Aussie debut 3 years ago. How pumped are you to be coming back here? What vibe did you get from Aussie audiences?
Pumped is not even close to describing it. It's just the most miraculous place. There's something about those venues, I can't put it into words, but there's this electricity there. There's like a thirst for joy and for life. And the audiences are so musical. They love to sing, they love to dance and clap and stomp. And it just feels so freaking good to be there.
Oh, well, yeah, Australia is the perfect venue for you. You've been working on this project for a number of years as well. What can fans expect?
Oh, a whole bunch of different genres, different styles, different sound worlds. Come ready to sing, because the audiences at the shows tend to do a lot of singing, and it's always such a wonderful feeling to sing together. Thousands of people's voices in one go. And so there are six of us on stage. We play kind of every genre under the sun. And as a team, we try and just bring as much joy as it's possible to bring.
Yeah. Hey, just a few days ago, you joined Coldplay and Natalie Imbruglia on stage, and you honoured Olivia Newton-John. Yeah, we've got a little snippet of it. What a beautiful tribute. What was that like?
Oh, it's completely and utterly surreal. Never once in my life have I played to a crowd of 90,000 people. I don't know how many times I'll be able to do that. But it is so, so cool. And Chris is such an angel. And he makes that huge room feel so small and so intimate. And he is one of the coolest people I've ever had the pleasure of meeting.
Well, Wembley looked as crazy busy as your music room you're sitting in now at the moment. It's unbelievable. You mentioned before your audience, they need to get ready to sing. You transformed the audience at one of your concerts into an incredible choir. We're going to show people that too. Could have went incredibly wrong, but it was fantastic. What a moment. So is that how interactive all your shows are going to be?
Absolutely. I try and do that at every single show because it's hard to explain, but there's something so intuitive about music and people who come to the shows, they tend to know how it fits together. Mm. And so at the end of the show, we finish by doing this singing moment, and it gives me goosebumps every single night without fail. But I have a feeling that down under, it's going to be unlike anything else I've ever experienced. I think it's going to be crazy down there.
Oh, yeah, you should pay the audience, Jacob. your new single...
Probably should, yeah.
Your new single, Never Gonna Be Alone, features John Mayer and Lizzie McAlpine. We're going to take a listen. Take me back through the window. Take me back through the door. You'll be right where I left you. Sitting on the floor. No, I'm never gonna be alone. Do you have as much fun in the studio as you do on stage?
It's a different flavour of fun, but it's equivalent amounts. You know, when you're in the studio, you're throwing paint, you're following your goosebumps, you're seeing what works, what feels good. on your own in isolation or collaborating, but on stage with a band, all of us bring a different kind of element to the show. And it feels like such a more kind of cathartic and extroverted approach. But ultimately, the fundamental creative energy, I think, is similar. Both two very important sides of the coin for me.
Oh, well, what an early Christmas present this is going to be. Jacob Collier's Jesse Volume 3 and his single Never Gonna Be Alone are both out now. For tickets, head to frontiertouring.com. Jacob, it's been such a pleasure to speak to you. Can't wait till you get down here.
You guys too. See you soon. Lots of love.
All the best, mate.